Hello everyone, iSchool Tech here. Now, before I say anything about what this video actually is about, I want to just say the iOS update withdrawal is officially over. I was recording this video and Apple dropped iOS 16.3.1 to the public just with a couple bug fixes here and security updates, so I just want to mention them really quick because I know some of you will be asking. iCloud settings may be unresponsive or incorrectly displayed if apps are using iCloud. That was a big complaint, finally been fixed. Siri requests were fine, mine may not work. This I have not had any experience with, actually. So this is the first that I'm hearing of this. But if you were having that issue, it has been fixed in 16.3.1. And crash detection optimizations for the iPhone 14 lineup, which we've seen several times by now. So hopefully we will see improvements with car crash detection. Hopefully none of you or myself will have to find out, because that is not good if we do. But let's just hope that all the issues that people were having have been fixed. So there's also security content with this release. If you do want to read that, it might not be out right now, so you might have to wait a couple hours to see what has been fixed, but I would recommend updating. This came at just over 330 megabytes on my 14 Pro Max and just over 100 megabytes on my 2022 iPad Pro. All right, so let's rewind the clocks back to good old 2013 when everything started going flat. iOS 7 was announced at WWDC in June with a radically different design. That sparked a lot of controversy from day one. Now, for two different reasons. The first reason was the design itself. Of course, people usually don't like change. I think that's a well-established fact. Even I don't like change. At the same time as I love it, it's some weird stuff. I think that might be most people. But iOS 7's design, it went flat, doing completely away with the skeuomorphic design, which, by the way, if you don't know what skeuomorphism is, it's basically when, for example, the design language of iOS represented real life materials and real life objects. And so they completely did away with that after they ran out of green felt, and you know, they shifted over to this flat design that a lot of people thought was childish. It wasn't just the fact that the design was childish, there was also plenty of other issues, such as the parallax effect being too strong initially, and it was causing, some people were having motion sickness from the parallax effect, or it was making their head hurt, and so that contributed more to the I hate this factor. But it wasn't just the design, it was the fact that it wasn't really a choice. So back in 2013, even 2014 and 15, we did not have the option to disable auto updates. That wasn't introduced till much later on, and where now you can go into settings, general software update, and turn off automatic downloads or automatic installations for iOS releases. Back then you couldn't do that. So what happened was a lot of people were waking up in late 2013 to a whole new design on their phones, you know, these devices that they relied on every day and for sometimes very critical work. This whole new design, you know, and it's really overwhelming. It's an overwhelming feeling, especially to some people. They have to feel like they need to relearn something now, and that's not good. And so I think if auto updates did exist, it wouldn't have been as bad, which we'll touch on a little bit later when I discuss why I think the time is right for an iOS refresh. So I want to talk about what this new design could be. So a couple days ago, I released an iOS 17 concept. And it was really modeled, which I think a lot of people are expecting it to be, after macOS Big Sur, in terms of the icons, and I guess the general design language as well. So macOS Big Sur's icons are pretty much identical to iOS's current icons, but with depth, shadows in the icons with depth, and they look much more modern, and the fact that there's depth, and I guess in some of the icons, you could argue that it actually looks a little bit textured. Like in the notes icon, the reminders icon, you will see that there is actual texture there in the detail. And so macOS Big Sur is a little bit more like skeuomorphism. It just brings something back. It brings character back, uniqueness back. And so I think a lot of people liked that with macOS Big Sur. Don't get me wrong, there was a lot of controversy over macOS Big Sur, but not as pronounced as with iOS 7, for example. I do want to mention, a few days ago I released a concept of an iOS 17 redesign that a lot of people really liked. So if you guys want to check that out, all my concepts, my entire Twitter page will be linked in the description below. Click on that link, it'll be right there. You don't even have to really scroll that far. All the concepts, you can take a look at those yourself. And there's been this trend with Apple that I've noticed is when they are going to redesign something, they don't really fix bugs unless they are critical to the user experience. They'll kind of just not touch whatever that is. In this case, that is the control center. So for example, when you swipe down to access the control center, the accessories, the home accessories, the platters flash, the backgrounds flash, you know, like you guys can see right here, swipe down and those platters, they just flash. I don't know why they do that. And especially if you have to touch into a platter, go back, they do the same. The point is though, they haven't touched the control center at all. Because there's no point in fixing issues like those, you know, minor visual glitches, if they're gonna redesign it anyway. In iOS 16.0 beta 3, they reinstated the iOS 12 era and earlier, iOS 9 to 12 era animations system-wide for haptic touch. When you long press on that link or that app icon, it will kind of pop out now, like it used to in iOS 12 and iOS 10 and iOS 11 and 9. Whereas in iOS 13 and 14 and even iOS 15, when you long press on an icon or a link or something else, it would recess and then pop out. They didn't bring that to the control center. In fact, the control center still uses the same animations from iOS 13. Why is that? And considering that they brought these animations back system-wide in iOS 16 makes me wonder, need new design. So it's about time. Now, so that's what I think the new design is gonna look like. And I think it'll be a lot easier for Apple to avoid controversies like with iOS 7 if they redesign iOS 17. Because again, auto update exists. The design has already been a thing for 2 years. Almost, it'll be 3 years if iOS 17 is redesigned because Big Sur has already had it. So if you use a Mac and then you update to iOS 17, see this new design, you're already familiar with it. You know that design language, so there's no learning curve to it. If you've been using an iPhone for a really long time, but you don't have a Mac, you've never used a Mac maybe, it's still very familiar. You'll still look at that and be like, oh, that's the Messages app, that's the Health app, that's the Wallet app. Nope, that's Settings, I love that. Favorite app. Settings and Music are my favorite apps. Comment what your favorite iOS default built-in apps are in the description below. Comment what your favorite built-in app is. My two are Settings and Music, but I think Apple Music does take the cake on that one for obvious reasons. But anyway, moving on. So why I think it is still very possible that iOS 17 is the redesign that we've been waiting for. So, first of all, looking back at 2013 with iOS 7, iOS got a redesign in 2013. Apple Watch did not exist yet. A lot of products didn't exist yet. But macOS didn't get a redesign. Actually, OS 10 did not get a redesign until a year later in 2014 with OS 10 Yosemite. That is when they brought the flat design language over to macOS. We've seen that happen a couple times, like in 2018 when macOS Mojave received dark mode. iOS 13 was the first version of iOS to have dark mode, and that wasn't until a year later in 2019. So this trend has been going on for quite a while, and there's several other examples too that you could find, but I fully expected iOS 15 in 2021 to get a redesign, to get a Big Surification, if you will, which never happened. But then I realized the Apple Watch exists. The Apple Watch exists. So now they have to maybe take, you know, an extra year, get the Apple Watch design refined to be consistent with iOS. Then iOS 16 comes out. Did not happen. And we've had several third-party icon updates in between these WWDCs that would indicate otherwise that iOS would have been receiving a redesign. Never happened though, but you know, that's whatever it is. iOS 16 though, did not get a redesign. And then I realized a few days ago, I was thinking, and I'm like, you know what? iOS isn't the same anymore. It's very different. It's a lot deeper. There's a lot more to do in iOS. There is a lot more functionality, a lot more features, even per app. There's so many, with the exception of probably Calculator, there's a couple apps, but there's so much more depth to iOS. It's gonna take longer for them to redesign everything, to be consistent, to make sure everything is, you know, ready to go for this redesign on top of the Apple Watch. And so I think it is really fair to say that by the time they could have had a redesign done, which probably would have been iOS 16 at the earliest, just wait an extra year and then release the redesign at the 10-year anniversary of iOS 7. And I think that makes the most sense. On top of that, you also have to consider iPhone 15. So we're hearing a lot of leaks that iPhone 15 is supposed to receive a design update, not a full-fledged redesign, of course, but we're supposed to see a return of semi-rounded corners, which I'm really excited for, by the way. They look really nice. The renders that are coming out, beautiful. Probably the most attractive phone ever. I regret using that word, but I'm going to roll with it. It's not just the iPhone 15, the iPhone 15 Pro, the iPhone 15 Pro Max. It is now the leaks of the iPhone 15 Ultra. Think about it this way. macOS Big Sur was redesigned in light of the Apple Silicon transition, a big step for Mac. In this case, an iPhone 15 Ultra, an all-new iPhone that would very likely have an all-new design, it would make sense to have an all-new iOS to match it. And that's usually what happens. Look at the iPhone 5C in 2013. iPhone 5C was designed with iOS 7 in mind. I think it's the right time. I'm gonna end this video here. So that is all I have for this video. Now, if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, or of course if you want anything clarified, this is the first video I've made in a while. Also, I think I'm coming down with something right now, so I'm kind of like all over the place. If you do need anything clarified, please let me know in the comments below. I will try to respond to you as best as possible to clarify, just be like, hey, this is what I meant by this, blah, blah. If you have anything to say, any extra thoughts maybe that you have while watching this video, definitely let me know in the comments. I try to read all your comments, so it's really interesting too to see what other people think. If you have any suggestions about the setup, yeah, seriously guys, with the setup, all new setup, my face, if you don't want to ever see my face again, that's also a different comment. Let's not be that rude though, okay? Any suggestions, comments about the setup, definitely let me know as well. I'll get back to you for that. And take into account whatever the feedback is, unless it's like, I hate you, you suck, get out of the camera. That's a different story. If you did find it enjoyable, helpful in any way, make sure to leave a like down below as well as hit that subscribe button. Again, we got it. We got to get that number up there. Stay tuned for more content, hopefully like this. That's all I have for this video. I will see you guys in the next one.